government while simultaneously being the rape capital of a continent. Sweden's come up with a novel new way of addressing its rampant rape problem. Stop importing the rapists? No. Arrest and fine the people who complain about it. One guy who said Muslim migrants were responsible for a lot of the rapes in Sweden was fined $1,265 for committing a crime of opinion. A crime of opinion. Now, where have I seen that kind of thing before? Swedish police officer Peter Springer is under investigation for merely observing that foreign-born offenders are largely responsible for the country's gang rape problem. Are people actually being prosecuted for telling the truth? Well, obviously, yes. But the Swedish government can still claim plausible deniability, because they refuse to break down crime statistics based on ethnicity or nationality. That would be racist, and it would also prove everyone right, and we can't have that, can we? But a private study of 4,142 rulings regarding sex-related crimes passed by 40 Swedish courts between 2012 and 2014 found that 95.6% of rapes were committed by men of foreign descent. 2 out of 3 rapes with aggravated circumstances were committed by newly arrived migrants or approved asylum seekers. Official crime statistics show that reported rapes have increased 34% in the last 10 years. But don't worry, because Sweden's feminist government is fighting back by changing sexist street names. Sweden is so politically correct. The police responded to a recent wave of grenade attacks, including grenade attacks against police stations, by expressing concern for those who pull the pin. Sweden is so politically correct. It hired a Muslim migrant to be head of its National Heritage Board, a guy who admits he hasn't, quote, read anything about cultural heritage, and opposes Swedes who want to protect their culture. Meanwhile, Iron Age Viking artifacts are being declared meaningless and melted down. Sweden is so politically correct. One of its leading cultural journalists says Swedes don't deserve their own national day and that, quote, nationalism should be wiped out. Sweden is so politically correct. They put their biggest export since ABBA and IKEA furniture on an official hate list.
Sweden's hate registry? Okay. Okay. Jontron, that makes sense. He's a Nazi. Pooter pie. No. Why?
Sweden is so politically correct. Swedish clothing giant H&M removed a line of socks because Muslims complained that a Lego pneumatic drill, when turned upside down, resembled the word Allah. Sweden is so politically correct. A mother who housed an Afghan refugee, who then raped her daughter, refused to report him to the police. Sweden is so politically correct. A bishop in a Swedish town approves the broadcast over loudspeaker of the Allah Akbar Muslim call to prayer for the good of society.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Sweden is so politically correct. Priests are demanding Swedes stop celebrating their own national holiday because it might offend migrants. Sweden is so politically correct. An Iranian-born immigrant who advocates limiting immigration is being called a Nazi.
You are an immigrant from a Muslim family, and yet you've taken a hard line against Muslim immigration, mass immigration from Muslim countries. What's the response been to you?
If we want to help people, and that is truly what we want to do, you cannot put so much pressure to the system that the system collapses under its own weight. And the response I've been having, because I'm, you know, merely putting this statement out that saying, look, there's a limit to how many people you can take in, has been to call me basically Uncle Tom, a house nigger. I've been compared to Dr. Mengele, you know, and this is not from random people on the street. These are people who have prominent posts in parties, in the left, in newspapers.
Sweden is so politically correct. A campaign was launched to classify asking someone where they are from as racist. Sweden is so politically correct. Newspapers pay home shaming visits to people who criticize mass immigration on the internet. Look at the weather forecast in Sweden compared to the weather forecast in Iraq.
Under eftermiddagen och kvällen blir det molnigt, regnskurar med åska i stora delar av Svealand.
تبقى درجة الحرارة العظمى مساوية لما سجلته نهار الثلاثاء عند درجة الحرارة العظمى.
Sweden is so politically correct. Migrant gang rapists are going free, while hard-working business-owning immigrants are being deported on technicalities. Sweden is so politically correct. It's paying for the fact that 58% of welfare payments go to migrants by raising the retirement age for everyone else. Sweden is so politically correct. A pensioner was prosecuted for hate speech for saying she saw migrants setting fire to cars, something that happens all the time in Sweden. She was prosecuted for expressing, quote, a disparaging view of refugees, or as it's otherwise known, telling the truth. Sweden is so politically correct. A Swedish government report said putting the word refugees in quotation marks is hate. The report also said questioning the age of, quote, child refugees is also hate, despite Sweden's own medical agency admitting that 3/4 of, quote, child migrants or adults. A Swedish dentist who through his own study confirmed that 80% of child migrants weren't children was fired. Again, in Sweden, telling the truth is hate speech. Telling the truth is thought crime. Sweden is so politically correct. Another government commissioned report said that milk was a racist symbol of white supremacy. Those ISIS flags being hung in Swedish migrant centers though, nah, who cares? Sweden is so politically correct. A female politician who was beaten up by an Arab gang felt guilty for being racist. Sweden is so politically correct. Swedish feminists are on television defending Muslim polygamy. Sweden is so politically correct. An Islamist who wants to live in an Islamic state and advocates wife beating was given the green light to start a school. And Muslim migrants with 3 wives and 16 kids are being given 3 separate taxpayer funded homes while the rest of the population struggles through a housing shortage. Sweden is so politically correct. It's giving returning ISIS jihadists therapy, welfare, and housing. Sweden is so politically correct. Homeschooling is banned, but Swedish social services allow returning ISIS jihadists to raise children. Sweden is so politically correct. After rapes began to skyrocket, authorities in Stockholm forced a clinic to withdraw treatment for rape victims and devote the centre to treatment of traumatised Muslim migrants instead. Sweden is so politically correct. It sees the positive side of soaring knife attacks and shootings. More medical knowledge to treat wounds. Sweden is so politically correct. Its multicultural and Islamophobia expert went on to join ISIS. You don't get much more politically correct than that. I'm not even listing all the examples I've read about. This is just a small selection. Oh, and remember when the media and all those lovey celebrities attacked me for saying Malmo had big problems with migrant crime? What happened since? Police in Malmo are now armed with machine guns. Gang rapes are becoming commonplace. Jewish chapels are being firebombed. Malmo's radio stations are being hijacked to play ISIS recruitment songs. And the UK government posted an official warning about gang-related crime, including shootings and explosions in Malmo. Sounds like a haven of tranquility. Given all this, is it any wonder that ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi is rumoured to be hiding in Sweden? Home sweet home. Multiculturalism in Sweden has clearly failed. Look at this picture of a Swedish class. This isn't multiculturalism, it's monoculturalism. Demographic studies show ethnic Swedes will be a minority in their own country within the lifetimes of most people currently alive. And the Council of Europe says Sweden is not taking in enough migrants. Sweden is an authoritarian country. It actively punishes and prosecutes people for telling the truth. Whether Sweden will become Europe's first Islamic caliphate remains to be seen. But if Swedes don't vote for significant change in this September's elections, Sweden will obliterate itself.